the executive lounge on the 41st floor of the Intercontinental Hotel in Warsaw. My name is Craig Smith, and I'm the publisher of Europa Property Real Estate Guides, and I'm here today with Thom Barnhardt from CEE Business Media. Thom is publishing several business magazines, and today we're here to discuss the next big forum and awards gala that is covering the shared services sector and BPO and taking place in New York City. Thom, welcome, and thank you for taking this time on a holiday Saturday.
Better than being outside.
And we'll even show you what it looks outside a little bit later at the end.
Don't do that.
Right now, we really want to get right into what you're doing with this event in New York. I see it's on the 28th of June at the New York Athletic Club. So just tell us, why New York?
We're doing New York for some obvious reasons. For the shared services sector in Central Europe, the U.S. investors represent 50% of the investors in Central Europe. So if you look at Poland, Hungary, Czech Republic, Romania, 50% of the investors are coming from the United States. And so what we're trying to do is go beyond the Fortune 500 companies and reach into the mid-market U.S. companies. And these are thousands of such companies who are not yet familiar with the East European, Central European market, may not have consolidated back office operations yet, and we think there's great potential there.
All right, great. So basically, the attendees are medium-sized U.S.-based companies, not yet in Central Europe, and looking to set up their shared services operations in Poland, Central Eastern Europe, Southeastern Europe.
Correct. And keep in mind, when you say mid-market companies in the U.S., these are still $500 million to $1 billion companies,
right,
not small companies
from
the perspective of Central Europe.
Exactly. U.S.-based.
And then you may not have ever heard of the company.
Right. Yeah. And now, I understand you're doing the summit and awards. Well,
yes.
The most important part of any awards event is of course, or in Summit too, is always the speakers and the jury. And as being an awards guy, I'm more interested in that part. So tell us a little bit about who's on this jury.
Well, we've been working a long time to get top level jury members, and what we're targeting is American investors who already have big operations in the CEE region. So if we're trying to have a peer-to-peer networking between the mid-market companies in the U.S., they most want to talk to those who are already operating shared service centers here.
Mm-hmm.
So, for example, we have on our jury NASDAQ, their global director of NASDAQ from New York. We have State Street, we have Brown Brothers Harriman, we have Cisco, we have Citibank, we have Becton Dickinson, we have Johnson & Johnson. So very large Fortune 500 companies that have significant operations already in Central Europe, and they are absolutely well positioned to tell others what they're doing right, what they're doing wrong, give advice. And these are, in every case, global directors of these companies.
Wow. So it is a not-to-be-missed event if you're in this sector.
If you want to be interested in getting advice about shared service centers in Central Europe, it's definitely the place to be.
Excellent. So tell us a little bit more about what are the awards? What can you win an award for?
Yeah, well, in addition to the daytime conference, which is an important part of it, which, has a focus on ITO outsourcing, but also then shared service centers, the evening is an integral part of the day and evening event, and these are the awards. And we have 10 awards categories, and they're very simple. We have top American investor in Poland, top American investor in Hungary, in Czech Republic, in the Baltics, and in Romania. And then we've mirrored those same with the top ITO investor in those same markets. So that's the idea.
Yeah, when you say ITO, it's like Bulgaria comes to mind.
Yes.
Belarus comes to mind. I mean,
we do in fact have categories for Bulgaria and Serbia and Belarus for the ITO side. But in fact, we don't have them included in the shared service side because the shared service centers are not particularly in those markets. But at the same time, those markets are very, very strong on the IT outsourcing side and in fact are working for some major U.S.-based, Silicon-based IT companies.
Right, and who are your main partners in this event right now?
Well, first of all, we'd like to really have a shout out for the city of Krakow, which was quick to get involved with this. The city of Krakow is number 8 or 9 in the world for locations for shared service centers. Number 1 in Europe. They were very quick to recognize the idea of tapping into the U.S. market a bit more strongly. We also have from the Invest Pomerania, the city of Gdańsk, Gdynia,
who are
supporting the event. City of Poznan is coming. and the number of other investment agencies from across the region in terms of the cities or locations. Mm-hmm. But we also have had quick support as well from PwC, from Transparent, and from Skanska.
Oh, yeah, I saw them on the website. Yes. Great, great. And I saw on your website you have a lot of media partners from the U.S. It's just like business journal after business journal. It seems like you're controlling every city. What's going on with that?
Well, what we've done is we have a partnership with the largest American business media group, which is the U.S. Business Journals or American mm-hmm. City Business Journals, and we are promoting the event in 43 or in fact all of their U.S. business journals on their events pages. So if you look at any U.S. business journal, mm-hmm. you'll see in the events calendar section our event on every single of their websites. And this, again, is consistent with our focus on this mid-market mm-hmm. because these local business newspapers reach very, very deep into the local cities.
Right. Sounds like you're hitting them all for that part. And I also noticed it seems like every chamber of commerce from Central Europe is also supporting this. So I guess these are your real supporting partner base, yeah?
Yes. The other is the U.S. or the American chambers of commerce. And what we've done is we've asked a number of them to participate. Every single one has said yes. Mm-hmm. So we have the AmCham from Poland, AmCham from Latvia, from Lithuania, from Slovakia, from Hungary, and mm-hmm. from Romania. And that's important because they are really giving good advice to American companies, substantial, large American companies who have expanded here and need some continued advice and suggestions. But they also are an important first step for mid-market U.S. companies who might be looking at the Central European market. Mm-hmm. They might knock on the door the first time at the AmCham in Warsaw, for example.
Right, great. Well, again, the date is June 28th, New York City, New York Athletic Club. The website address?
Very simple, sharedservicesEurope.com.
SharedservicesEurope.com. It's also in the text to describing this, so if you want to go to the site and take a look there. Is there anything we've missed or any little key points that you would like to bring up before we wrap up the interview?
I think those are the key points. Mm-hmm. I mean, the main summary is that this is for American investors, mid-market American investors who are looking at the Central European market for shared service centers. And we are really well connected, as you know, Craig. I've been here mm-hmm. for 25 years between Poland, Hungary, Czech Republic.
Sure.
So we really are trying to give them advice, suggestions, and connect them to the right people mm-hmm. who give them good advice.
Oh, great. Okay. Yeah. Okay, great. So anyway, I'm very excited about going. I can't wait to get to New York. And
are you coming?
Yeah, well, definitely coming. Good. So I'll be there. You'll be there. I think a lot of our clients from the region will
Absolutely.
Be there. We're actually publishing another Europa Property CE office guide that will be launched at the ABSL conference okay. in Łódź, which I'm sure you'll be at.
I'll be there.
And you have a publication
we'll
as well
there.
For that.
We'll
yep.
be there. Yep.
And so that's coming out on June 12th. And then, of course, we'll have our office guides for Central Eastern Europe, Southeastern Europe, of course, for your event in New York. And if anyone would like any more information, of course, go to Thom's website or email him directly. Also, and I guess that's about it. Have a nice weekend, and I'll take this mic, say
Thank
goodbye.
You. Thank I'll, you for the interview.
I'll
Thank
take
you.
The little microphone off, Good. And I'll just give our viewers a little look of our
Oh, where
or
we are.
View from Good outside, idea. And then so we'll just come with us because I'm sure listening to us was also great. But here's a view from the outside and from the top of the Interconti. Warsaw looks actually very nice today.
The Palace of Culture.
Oh, we've got the Palace of Culture over there for all of our U.S. fans that would like to come here. So anyway, I think we'll wrap it up with that. So again, Thom, thank you very
thank
much,
you,
and we'll
Thanks very much.
We'll see you in New York.
Very good.
Okay.